Okay, so starting at the business end, this is the turbo diesel V8, manufactured February 2017. Dual battery system here with a TJM voltage regulator system, which is down here to maintain the condition of the batteries. That can also be switched to solar power or to charge directly off the alternator. Being the V8, of course, it's got the sexy bonnet bulge. And then for lighting up the road, we've got some additional driving lights in the heavy duty TJM bumper bar. We've got King's Spots, King's Light Bar, and the TJM winch here with the kinetic line. Heavy duty bar. And of course, this vehicle is mine spec, so we have our isolation switch, Oricom, it's the heavy duty off-road UHF antenna, and the full wraparound scrub bars from TJM, keep everything protected. We've got the Baja ATZ P3 light truck Mickey Thompson tyres with about 90% tread, pretty new tyres on there. The windscreen is brand new, had a couple of little chips, so the owner decided, oh well, let's put a whole new windscreen in. Aftermarket wide towing mirrors, they actually extend out as well if you have a really wide trailer on. See a little bit of paint missing on the base of that, you can repaint that or chrome it or whatever you want. Side steps for easy in and out. We have an auxiliary water tank under here which has a tap on either side of the vehicle, so that can be accessed from either side. Obviously, again, full mine spec, so we have the lock nut markers. The whole underside hasn't been touched, there's some light surface corrosion, I don't know if you can see. But we could have just painted it black and you'd never know the difference, but we thought we'd leave it totally untouched so you can see just how well maintained this vehicle has been. Both sides there's a toolbox, lockable toolbox on the sides here. You can keep bits and pieces and recovery gear. We have the full overtop awning with double Rhino racks on the roof for putting lights and conduits and things. This has a full 4-inch roll bar over top with strut supports. I'll pop this open. Probably the only real thing that needs to be done in this vehicle, these two zips on this side need a look at, and a couple of these press studs, well just about all the press studs need replacing, so that's something I'd recommend the new owner to do. If you look in the back, look, even comes with a little high-vis flag, spare wheel bolted up on the back. We have rear window protection from the mesh, triple overhead stringers, probably can't see that, it's a bit dark, and a fully fitted Bushranger rubber mat. And I've taken photos of the tray without the mat so you can see, being a boss's car, there's no dents. Oh, there's also the old roll lock, lockable roll door. It's a good place to keep recovery gear and shackles and things, but that's almost to the front, goes right the way to the water tank. The zips on this side is functional, but again, if you're going to get it serviced, the press studs need doing. The side latches are the double lock sort, so you have to push and then open, so that makes them a lot more secure on bumpy roads. Again, lockable toolbox both sides, and there's the second access tap for the water. A King's Adventure awning on the side here, that must be 3 meters. Go back so you can see, 3 meter length, and again mine spec, you got the high-vis reflective tape in the pearl silver. The seats in the vehicle have been covered from brand new with the heavy duty seat covers, which means the velour underneath is like brand new. And obviously these covers, black duck covers, can be removed and washed if you so desire. Entire roof lining pretty much unmarked. Again, unusual for an up north vehicle. And the carpets have been protected from new with the factory fitted rubber mats. Genuine Toyota. And around to the business end, we've got your mine site required fire extinguisher close at hand. It's the Boss Pack, so fully electric. A few little extras, we've got the EVC Ultimate Performance Throttle Body Control Module, which enables you to choose maps for different economy or power settings. And it's a little bit dark, Let me turn on some lights maybe. That's not going to help at all. But as you can see, freshly detailed. It has an Oricom UHF 380 radio installed. Have an aftermarket little cup holder there. This is actually a reverse camera, which is hitched up to the camera which is underneath the back of the tray, and there's also a dash cam for recording live while you're driving. Oh yeah, here, factory diff locks, so you can lock just the front, just the rear, or you can lock the front and the rear, so it has double diff locks, electronically controlled from here, traction control, electric everything, as you would expect. Full service history, serviced by the local mechanic who actually owns this same model car and was factory trained by Toyota. So he knows the vehicle very well, and this has been very well looked after. Even got a little custom Boss style velour armrest here with a big cup holder there for your takeaway cups, and that pops up as well if need be for a third seat. So that's a bit of an unusual addition as well. Front seats like the back seats, brand new underneath the covers. Nice blue-grey velour, and those seats, of course, seat covers provide brilliant protection. That's about it. Rhino racks on the roof, and we have here an AirTech snorkel fully plumbed in. There is one. Where is it? There. That is the paint blemish on this vehicle. There's a few little surface scuffs that will polish out, but that's the only bit of missing paint. Again, the aftermarket mirrors, that paint's flaking off there, so you can either respray that or replace them with chrome ones or whatever you want to do. But there we have it, a very nice, very well set up, over $10,000 worth of mine spec parts put on it to make it mine site compliant, but a very well looked after, well maintained, pride and joy of the lady boss that drives it. So looking for a new boss to take control of this beast. Well, any questions, drop them down below.